What's up? What's up? What's up? Dag Pill, man. Welcome to Bully Land. What's up? What's up? What's up? We in here, man. Lil Brunson back at you with the back at you. Notification gang, y'all in the building. Bang, bang, notification gang. Man, somebody just said Miles Garrett is going to tee off against this bad line. I am terrified about Miles Garrett. Terrified about Miles Garrett, bro. I ain't going to even lie. Terrified about Miles Garrett, man. What's going on, Petey? Big play Slay, what up? OG, what's up? Miles Garrett versus Lane Johnson. Lane Johnson been fooled all season. Listen, this might not be all positive. This might not be all positive. Good morning, Clay. What's up? Julian, what up? This might not be all positive, man. I'm going to keep it a buck. This might not be all positive this morning. What's going on? Produced by Swift, man. My God. You know what I'm saying? This might not be all positive. You know what I mean? I'm going to start with the obvious. Let's let it brew. Mike Banks, what's up? Lunchtime with the bullies in full effect. You already know. I ain't even gonna get the lunch yet. Look, they got the food trucks out here where I work at. You know what I'm saying? Might give me a little Jamaican cuisine. You know what I'm saying? A little oxtail over the rice real quick. I'm hungry too, but we got to talk first. You know, I hope I ain't hoping to holding up a parking spot for somebody that's hungry. You know what I'm saying? We got to talk first. D. Aldridge, what up? Jamaican D's, can't tell you my spots. Need to feed something spicy to Carson. You already know. Oh, this jacket, man, yeah, it was cold today, man. It was cold. It's a nice little wool joint. Where I get this from? I got this from Top Man, I think last year. You know what I mean? Just gotta dress with the weather. Am I watching a draft tonight? No. I'm not watching a draft tonight. I don't care about anything right now except Eagles football and how terrible we look. You know what I'm saying? I don't care about anything but that. This is the obvious, and we're going to state it right now, now that I feel like, you know, we got the right amount of people in here. The obvious is that if you lose to the Browns, it's a wrap. Listen, we got to just deal with that. They're going to clown Carson. Because the fact of the matter is this. The team is underperforming on the offensive end, and he is the quarterback. That's the bottom line. He's the quarterback. Now, I'm glad to see that a bit of the blame is going to where it really, really needs to go, which is Doug Peterson for calling these plays. I'm glad to see that. But they're always going to clown Carson Wentz. They're going to clown him. It's the popular thing to do. Nobody's not talking. You know, and I hate to even talk about other quarterbacks, bro, because it's whack. It's whack. But come on, man. Nobody's not talking about the obvious slump that Russell Wilson is in. Last two games, 4 picks, 2 touchdowns. Nobody talking about that. Listen, is the season salvageable? You'll see a difference in this offense. Listen, the offense can't play any worse. I think we averaged like 5 or 6 points a game in the first half. The offense can't get any worse. It can't get any worse. So the first thing you have to do if you want to salvage this is you have to change. Doug has to give up play calling now. Doug cannot go into the Browns game still calling the plays. Because Doug Peterson is not going to do the smart thing. Doug Peterson is not going to come into this thing with the mindset of, listen, I have to draw plays that take Carson Wentz away from Myles Garrett's side. If Myles Garrett is lined up on, if he's facing the left side of our formation, I need to roll Carson Wentz out to the right side. And we're going to talk about this later on in the week, how our plays should be formatted. Period. You have to run some misdirection to Miles Sanders' side while rolling Carson Wentz out to the opposite side of the field. And what do you know? And what do you know? Is Garrett on IR? I didn't know that. Somebody just texted me and said he was going to play. So if Garrett is on IR, somebody proposed a trade, huh? In my league, they need me now, huh? Now that I'm whooping. Listen, I'm so pissed with football. Listen, if Garrett isn't on IR, Kirsten, he playing? See, a lot of people saying he playing. I think he's playing. You gotta get Carson Wentz away from him, because the plays that Doug Peterson are calling has Carson Wentz in the fire of free running guys. He's just in the fire. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people saying he holding the ball too long. He doing this, he doing that. But realistically, think about it like this. Who is calling plays, or who is running plays as a quarterback? Who's running plays to just have to throw it away? Petey, man, welcome to Bully Land. Who's running plays to just have to throw the ball away? Think about it. Oh, he should just throw it away. That's a wasted down. If Carson Wentz just throws it away, we lose like 10 downs a game. Like 10 downs a game. At some point, you got to try to stand in there and deliver a pass. You got to. We would complain about, if Carson was throwing a ball away every time he probably should throw the ball away, we'd be complaining about that. You know what a throwaway looks like in the Philadelphia Eagles offense? This is a throwaway when you put Jalen Hurts in the game and run a goddamn quarterback keeper. That's as good as throwing the ball away. Because they basically don't work. That's a throwaway. A throwaway is taking a knee. Might as well take a knee. At some point, he has to stand in there and try to deliver a pass. Because you want to win the game, right? You want to win the game, right? So if you really want to win this game, you have to get him outside of the pocket. And we talked about this. 7 minutes left in the third quarter of the Giants game. You know what I mean? 7 minutes left of the third quarter in the Giants game. They rolled Carson Wentz out twice. Two back-to-back 40-yard plays. And guess what they did? And Doug, this is Doug. Doug didn't roll him out again. Doug the play caller, right? Doug didn't roll him out again after back to, listen, and you know Carson Wentz. You know Carson Wentz was number two in plays outside the pocket last year, only second to Russell Wilson. Why is that not a big emphasis in the game, in the game plan? Why is that not a big emphasis in the game plan? So if you want to win now, if you want to see change now, Doug has to give up play calling. And this is the reality of this. Doug ain't about to fire himself. No. It got to come from the guy in the thumbnail. Lurie has to make the change. Lurie has to make the change. And the way it's looking right now, to be honest, I don't see Doug. Doug ain't going to fire Peterson after this season. You're not going to fire Doug. Lurie will get him a play caller before he fire him. He will. Number two, make the offense Carson friendly. We talked about ways in rolling him out. Let's help him out in other ways. Switch up the playbook. Where are the screens? Doug Peterson calls the plays. Where are the screens? Where are the screens, and what is Marty Morningweg's job? He's an offensive consultant to Doug Peterson. Fire him. Fire Marty Morningweg. Fire him or give him a shot at calling the plays. Because for Doug, right now, Twitter, Philadelphia Eagles Live, watch love Doug Peterson speak with the media. I don't want to see it. I don't want to see it. I'd rather be here with y'all, honestly, because I'm tired of it. I don't want to hear the excuses. Don't want to see it. Screens have been ineffective. Well, I got news for you. 9 miles. I got news for you. We got 38 yards off the screen. We ain't even trying to run the screen. How you going to call something ineffective that you don't run? I stopped listening to Doug 5 weeks ago. Well, I can't listen to it. And, you know, listening to him usually makes for good content after the fact, because I could talk about key things that jumped out to me. But I might as well just tell you how I feel. I might as well do it. It don't matter what he's talking about. Because he also came out after the game and said he felt as though his play calling was good and crisp. You thought your play calling was good? Bro, that's like me going to the bathroom to take a crap, dumping on the floor and still flushing the toilet. It makes no sense. It makes no sense. You know what I mean? Doug Peterson is not going. He's not going to crap on my Wednesday afternoon with this speech. He ain't going to crap on my Wednesday afternoon. I am not going to listen to it right now. I'm going to eat my Jamaican food after this. I'm going to finish talking to y'all. And I'm going to go back to my desk and check up on some things before I go home. Doug Peterson is not going to do this to me today. He's not going to do this to me today. You know, listening to Doug lately got me wanting to just, you know, I don't, the first person I see walk across the street, I just want to just spare him. I just want to just body slam an innocent person. You know, I'm not going to listen to Doug Peterson today. I ain't doing it, bro. I'll listen to him some other time today. This is the third thing they got to do. The third thing they got to do is that you have to increase Miles Sanders' workload. You got to, bro. Why is Miles Sanders only carried the ball 20 times in one game? In 23 games that he played, why is Miles Sanders only carried the ball 20 times? Miles Sanders, I believe, is like the 10th player in NFL history after last week to rush for 80 or more yards in three consecutive games with 15 or less carries. Why is Doug Peterson holding these guys back from career days? Miles Sanders could have had 100 yards rushing three straight games. I don't think the Eagles ever had a running back that did that. We could have had it 3 weeks in a row. Why do you have Miles Sanders with 80 yards rushing and 15 carries? Miles Sanders was prepared to dismantle. Miles Sanders could have ran for 200 yards on them dudes, bruh. And then you know what leaning on Miles Sanders does? I need Miles Sanders with 30 carries, man. I need Miles Sanders with 30 carries against the Browns. I do. Because it helps us. It helps us. It helps us. Lord Brunson said he about to choke slam. Yeah, listen. It helps us. If you feed Miles, it helps us. This is basic football knowledge, man. With the way Miles Sanders was running the ball, the play action game could have been lethal. 3 weeks in a row, we could have been the best play action team in football. They were scared of Miles Sanders. The last three teams that Miles Sanders played against was petrified against him. We stopped running the ball. 6.8 yards a carry. We stopped giving him the ball. You know what else you don't get if you're running Miles Sanders? You get less penalties on running plays. It's documented. In running formations, this has to be a fact. I don't know. But I'm going to look it up. But in running formations, I'm pretty sure there's less penalties called. You only could get a holding for the most part. We running around here with Fulgham getting a false start at wide receiver. Just basically undisciplined. And then Jalen Reagor. When Jalen Reagor let the punt go over his head, I said he should have fielded it. That was bad. For him to openly come out and say, well, we would have been in the same spot had I fielded it or not, is the lack of accountability and the lack of discipline. These guys are walking around this locker room like they shit don't stink. They walking around the locker room like it don't stink. They walking around the locker room. Let me be a coach. And let me be the wide receiver coach and one of my wide receivers, you know, or the special teams coach. Let me be that guy and you come out there and basically have an oh well attitude. You won't field another punt for me. If I'm a special teams coach, Jalen Reagor will not be fielding another punt for me. Even though he might got the breakout speed to probably make a big play happen, but at least Greg Ward fields the punt. You know what I'm saying? Our special teams coach, Been bad. Go eat, LB. You too fired up. I mean, they ain't going nowhere. Look, ain't even no line. They ain't going nowhere. And if they do go somewhere, I'll go somewhere else. Ward messed up too on the punt. Yeah, Ward did mess up on the punt, but Jalen Reagor got to have a better attitude. You don't know everything. You're just a rookie, man. A lot of people want to give up on Reagor. I'm not going to give up on him yet, but you don't know everything. LT, thank you for the donation. Do not let Coach Press Taylor not get pressed too. I don't even know. What are these dudes' jobs? What are these dudes' jobs? Why do we have an offensive consultant? Why? Why do we have an offensive consultant? You know what I'm saying? I have a financial consultant. I have a financial advisor. When I spend a certain amount, like yesterday, I bought some stuff. I spent a certain amount of money. They called me. First they asked me was, did somebody take your card? Then they asked me, this ain't part of the plan. Why are you spending this much money at one time? They held me accountable. Now, at the end of the day, it's my money, but a consultant is supposed to be able to ask you these questions to have you thinking. Marty Morningweg should be in Doug Peterson's office, in his office, every day. Why are you not giving Miles Sanders the ball more? Why are you not rolling? You're a consultant, right? Get him out of here if he ain't going to do nothing. That's all I'm saying. Who has a higher ceiling, Doug as a coach or Wentz as a QB? Wentz as a QB. I'll tell you why. Because you can see how bad poor coaching can affect the quarterback. It's not about Carson Wentz. It's really not about Carson Wentz, man. It's not about him. When Carson Wentz, everybody talks about the 2017 season, we had the number one rushing attack in the sport. The running game helps. Jay Ajayi and Blunt could not be stopped. Every successful quarterback has a running back, bro. I'm telling you this. I'm telling you this. Lamar Jackson has a slew of running backs. Patrick Mahomes has a slew of running backs who can run and catch. You can have an average roster and a good coach can put them over the top. Agreed. 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 Russell Wilson, a slew of running backs. They all hurt, but Chris Carson is the man when he's in the game. Aaron Rodgers, Aaron Jones. Do I got to keep going? If Kirk Cousins did not have Dalvin Cook, he'd be on the chopping block every week. Dalvin Cook is salvaging the season for Kirk Cousins. Dak Prescott, Ezekiel Elliott. Should I keep going? Big Ben, Connor. The run game helps, bruh. And I don't think nobody has a higher yard per carriage than Miles Sanders. Saints, Alvin Kamara. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. They need to hire you as offensive coordinator, bro. They're going to overlook me, and they're going to give it to some cornball, and they're going to continue to lose, even if I applied. I know the game, but you think I wouldn't apply for it? The 49ers, a slew of running backs. The 49ers believe in a running back. Derrick Henry, come on. Come on. But they don't hear me, though. Nick Chubb, who probably about to arch our back this weekend at 1 o'clock. Nick Chubb. And Alvin Kamara. Baker Mayfield got his running backs. CMC the Panthers. Come on, but they don't hear me though. They don't hear me though. DeAndre Swift is not too soon. I like DeAndre Swift. Josh Jacobs, listen. Listen to me. Listen to me. Y'all see where I'm going with this. The fourth thing is the defense got to find some type of swagger, bro. The defense has to find some type of swagger. The defense is soft. The defense is just garbage. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of people got this right. Oh, the Eagles can't stop the run. The Eagles can stop a running back. They can't stop a quarterback from running. The quarterback keeper. Now, luckily, the rest of the teams on our roster probably not going to run the quarterback keeper until you go see Kyler Murray, who probably going to arch our back. You know what I'm saying? Everybody else in these next three games, they're not going to really run it. I don't really see the Seahawks putting Russell in that predicament to get him hit and banged up. He's a franchise quarterback. The defense lacks eye discipline. The defense lacks total discipline. Jim Schwartz's scheme has been bad for 3 years in a row now. 3 years in a row. You know what I'm saying? It's been bad for 3 years in a row. Listen, at the minimum, Matt, you got to be looking at a Jim Schwartz-less defense. You got to be looking at getting a new defensive coordinator at the minimum. At the minimum. I can understand Doug possibly coming back, but Doug coming back means Doug is coming back with the offensive coordinator attached to him at the hip. Attached to him at the hip. Period. Get Schwartz out of here, please. You got to. We need to get Goddard involved more. I mean, I think God, I don't even think Goddard is 100%. Then everybody with this, oh, well, Zach Ertz is coming off of IR. So what? Nothing is going to change unless somebody else is calling the plays. I'm telling you, bruh. I'm telling you. If Doug Peterson really think his play calling was good, he tripping, bro. Carson Wentz shouldn't have threw the ball more than 20 times in that game. It's impossible. Listen, the running lanes were open so wide, Boston Scott ran like a 60-yard touchdown. The running lanes was wide open in that game. We kept throwing the ball. We kept throwing the ball because we gotta get Rager involved. Oh, Alshon's back. We gotta work him in immediately. Come on, man. Pick up Jordan Howard, man. Why would anybody want to come back? Why would anybody want to come here this year? Honestly, think about it. They should have got Fournette, bro. Did you hear Lincoln Riley and Howie was talking about what? How we can go to? We need to look at Saints offensive coordinator, other coaching personnel. They want be contenders anymore. I feel like, I mean, look, bruh, stuff got to change, man. It got to change, and it got to start changing in a manner in which we need to start seeing results on the field. The more games we lose, the more Carson Wentz is going to get criticized, but Carson Wentz is only running the program that he's being advised to run. I actually feel sorry for him. He's only running the program that he's being advised to run. He's not getting no... He, you know what I'm saying? He's not running an idiot-proof program. He's not running an idiot-proof program. Stop bringing Jalen Hurts in the ball game and putting Carson Wentz out at wide receiver. Nobody believes that. Nobody believes any of that stuff. Nobody. Nobody believes it. Nobody believes any trickery is coming from that. You know what I mean? Jordan Howard always tough to tackle. Yeah, but guess what happened when we had Jordan Howard? He was a healthy scratch. A healthy scratch. Brought him in and stopped giving him the ball. Brunson, do you think the change in OC and QB coaches hurt Carson? I mean, I don't think the change in offensive coordinator hurt Carson because, hey, Cool Eagle, man, what's up, bro? I don't think the change in offensive coordinator, Cool Eagle says there's no motivation, no energy with these guys. This is purely a coaching and front office problem. I agree, man, I agree. I don't think the offensive coordinator coaching change hurt him because you didn't replace the coordinator. You took the offensive coordinator away. The quarterback change definitely hurt him. Mechanics has suffered. Timing is off. Everything, yes. When you take away guys like that, it hurts them. It hurts them. Dak Prescott been good, explosive, 2 years in a row up until he got hurt. Kellen Moore is still there. You see what I'm saying? Kellen Moore is still there. You can't just be switching dudes. I mean, I understand dudes go other places and they get other jobs. But come on, man. Doug Peterson, man, you're being boldly selfish. You're being selfish and it's to your detriment. You want to call the plays and you want us to believe that you think you... Come on, we don't believe you that you think you did a good job. You just got to say it. You just can't go up there and admit to your coaching staff and to your players that you should not be calling these plays. That's the part about being a leader. The part about being a leader. Trust me, from a natural born leader. That's a part of it, bro. That's a part of it. Come on, bro. I got little brothers that look up to me, man. One just graduated college. One about to graduate this year. You know what I'm saying? And I ain't been the perfect big brother, but I let them know when I slip, like, damn, that was my bad. I'm not above humanity to not be able to talk about my mistakes. When you're supposed to be a leader of men, a quarterback, listen, an NFL coach is a leader of grown men. These are grown men. Jason Peters is a grown man. Damn near 40. You got to be able to tell a grown man when you put them in a position to fail them. Not going for the extra points. What are you thinking, Doug Peterson? Why wouldn't you not have a three-point? Why wouldn't you make it a three-point game? What good is it to make it a two-point game? We don't believe you're going to go for the game-winning field goal because you ain't even kicking extra points. What is the point of that, bro? I didn't even like it when he went for it the first one. What's the point of this stuff, bro? What's the point of this stuff that we're seeing? Come on, bro. Do I still believe we went in a division? Listen. Listen, bro. Bruh. Do I look like I believe we went in a division, Petey? Honestly. And you know I'm the most optimistic guy. I'm the most optimistic Eagles YouTuber on YouTube. Hell no. No, I don't believe we went in a division. No. Do you see the slop that we go out there? We have not won a 1 o'clock game. It's fucking week 13. What week is it? We ain't win a week 13 game. We ain't win a 1 o'clock game yet. Luke's of Hazard, team is too complacent. Fire. Well, you gotta fire a bunch of people, bro. Listen, we haven't won a 1 o'clock game. No, I understand, Marcus. I understand you had the X, but let's keep it a buck now. Now I'm going to do my thing and always give you guys ways to why we should be winning these games and ways and how we can prepare for the upcoming week. That's just what's in me. It ain't like the coaching staff going to do what I say anyway. I swear, man, if these dudes would have followed the keys to victory from week one, we have two losses, bro. Two losses. It's ridiculous, man. It's ridiculous. Y'all just had to let Minnesota get Justin Jefferson. Bruh, I don't know what hurts me more, DK Metcalf or Justin Jefferson. I don't know. Listen, it's a timeline. It's a timeline that I'm putting together that can show you how we got here, bruh. It takes some real going back to my old videos, but it's a timeline. When I said get DK Metcalf, and everybody told me he's always hurt. Why do you want DK Metcalf? Number two in receiving yards now. That's a part of the timeline. The timeline when I said get Justin Jefferson, he slipped. Go get him. Come on, bro. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. And you know what I'm saying? We've been spoiled as a fan base. Three straight trips to the playoffs. But now it's about time. We go through our dark phase and see what we really built. See how we really built as Eagles fans. It's about time we go through that dark phase and see how we really built. Because nothing is guaranteed on a Sunday. So what happened since 2017 for the org to look like this? I'll tell you what happened since 2017. We gave up on power running. We started getting cheap. We didn't bring back Blunt. We could have brought back Blunt on a one-year deal. We tried to be cheap and bring back a hurt Jay Ajayi. We gave up on power running. That's one of the biggest concerns. We gave up on power running after 2017. I think Blunt left us. Ajayi got hurt, and we start being cheap. Spoiled how? Come on, dog. Spoiled by going to the playoffs three straight years and one resulting in a Super Bowl. Nobody else in our division has that luxury. That can spoil a fan base. Spoiled by always thinking that no matter how bad it looks in the middle of the season, that we're going to find a way to win a division. That's what happened last year. You know what I'm saying? Some of y'all are the type of Eagles fans who don't respect their franchise unless they get multiple Super Bowls in a row. That's just not realistic, man. Teams need those dark phases to self-reflect. Absolutely. But the biggest thing for me, man, is giving up on the power game. Thinking that you can have some sort of a power game with Corey Clement, who couldn't find the hole on X videos. You see what I'm saying? And Miles Sanders. That's not a power game, even though Miles Sanders can get you 25 carries. Carson on the coast with Frank Wright. Listen, Carson on the coast is a Super Bowl team. I almost wish Carson Wentz got traded so we could really see how he should be utilized. Because I hate to see him go through this. I hate to see him go through the scrutiny, bruh. I hate it. Because I seen a properly coached Carson Wentz. I hate to see him go through this, bruh. I hate it. Carson Wentz on the Raiders. Oh, my God, bruh. Oh, my God. They'd be dangerous. We not spoiled winning terrible divisions at 8-9. Listen, DH Eagle. How many years have the Patriots won a terrible division? How many years have the Patriots won a terrible division? I don't care about division talk. As long as you win your division, you did your job. I don't care how bad the rest of your division is. How many years have the Patriots won a division, bruh? Come on. How many years have the Saints won a division? That division always been trash and mediocre. Come on, man. Come on. Teams win bad divisions all the time. All the time. I'm not blaming other teams for playing poorly for my record. If the other teams play poorly, we should be 6-0 every year, right? Patriots never win with 9-7, but they can if they wanted to because the division's that bad. Would I trade for Baker? No, Baker is trash. Hell no, I wouldn't trade for no Baker Mayfield. We could have Hopkins, but see, Hopkins is unrealistic. We just can't throw out names. We couldn't afford Hopkins. LB, who your MVP right now? Right now, my MVP probably Patrick Mahomes. I think he only got one interception still. The Bills and the Dolphins just got good. Just got good. The Bills and the Dolphins just got good, and the Patriots were still favored to win the division. You can't afford Hopkins. You cannot afford Hopkins. Y'all got to understand something. Hopkins wanted a new deal, which is why Hopkins left on the current extension, and he got re-extended when he hit the Cardinals, I believe. But anyway, man, Kyler Murray, my MVP, you tripping. Kyler Murray ain't no MVP. Kyler Murray got a couple people in front of him. Russell still might be in front of him, even though he's having a bad slump. But it's definitely Patrick Mahomes, honestly. Dalvin Cook might be ahead of him, too. Did you see how Orlando was disrespecting Carson? Listen, that's what they're going to do because it's the hot topic. It's the hot thing to do. Hot thing to do. Carson Wentz has got to not listen to that noise, man, because he's going to play better eventually, whether it's with us or not. Whether it's with us or not. But I can't. I watched the game again. I really couldn't think of nothing that Carson Wentz did wrong. Everybody's in my DMs talking about, oh, do you see these balls hitting the ground that Carson Wentz throwing? Bro, do y'all see the balls being tipped? Do y'all see the balls being tipped, though? Come on, bro. The commentators nationally, too, on TV while the game is on. That's just a bad throw. You just can't miss an 8-yard check down. And then when they show you the replay, oh, that's why it missed, bro. You ready to jump down his throat before you see the replay that the ball was tipped. Miles dropped a couple, too. Orlando Scandrick is a bum. Orlando Scandrick, I don't even think Orlando Scandrick ever played in the playoffs, bro. Orlando Scandrick's best game was with us. Was with us against the Jets. Orlando Scandrick is a lifelong bum. I'm not worrying about what Orlando Scandrick got to say in terms of football. In terms of football. You know what I'm saying? Nobody not talking about Kelce either. Doug is still talking nonsense this press conference right now. I mean, now I'm going to watch it because you said that, Kirsten, but I'm not stopping what I'm doing to watch no nonsense, to watch nobody lie to me, man. If I want somebody to lie to me, I could watch Fox News or something. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to sit here and watch this dude lie to me. Tip balls can also fall on the QB sometimes, though. Somebody said that in my DM, too. Carson is still getting balls batted down. I don't understand how that's his problem. But y'all got it. I don't understand. I'm not excited for the Browns game. I'm excited for every Eagles game. I'm not going to hold you. I'm excited for every Eagles game. But if we do beat the Browns, I'm not going to feel like, you know, it's all turned around. If we beat the Browns, Listen, the Browns didn't look that good against the Texans. I think it was a low-scoring game like 10-7. But the Browns are going to try to run the ball down our throat. I'm telling you. And then they're going to roll Baker out and play actionless, man. That's what I would do. Tip ball is a bad pass protection. I mean, I thought that too, but hey, apparently I don't know everything. You know what I'm saying? Let's not get to Kelce. You know, somebody tried to argue me down that bad snaps don't throw teams out of rhythm. So if your quarterback got to pick the ball off the ground on a play that was designed for a three-step drop and to get the ball out, that ain't throwing out the rhythm? Come on, bro. Rule Girl, what up? You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't understand that. A bad snap damn sure could throw the rhythm off, man. Like, let's be real here. Let's be for real. I know we all want to go to Carson Wentz's house with a pitchfork and tell him to come outside, but everything ain't his fault. I played center for 8 years. Yeah, and you know the importance of a good snap then. A lot of teams had some bad snaps last week, yeah? And I'm pretty sure it affected each and every one of those possessions. What's going on, Saddam? You ain't missed much, man. We were just going over, you know, some things that got to change in order to, you know, turn this thing around immediately. The number one thing was Doug has to, right now, after Doug get finished lying to us in our face at the press conference, he needs to relinquish play calling duties. He needs to relinquish play calling duties right now, right now. After he get finished telling us the sky is what? What color is the sky today for Doug? Mocha, the sky is the color of vanilla bean coffee. He need to get rid of, he need to stop with the play calling. Stop it. He need to stop. We just got to make sure that Carson does not hold on to the ball too long. But listen, like I said in the beginning of this post, yeah, he's holding on to the ball too long. Yeah, he should throw it away. But the plays break down so fast and the plays are just so bad at times. The calling is so bad that if Carson Wentz throws the ball away every time he should throw the ball away, he'll waste 10 downs a game. Realistically, in today's NFL with these supreme athletes, I don't think a quarterback should throw the ball away more than three times in the game. A busted screen play, yeah, you got to throw that in the dirt. A sack on a third down when you're in field goal range, you got to get out of the pocket and you got to throw that away. Them like the only real times, you know what I'm saying? Them like the only real times, but if you're about to take a hellacious hit, yeah, throw it away too. But at the same time, we want Carson Wentz to throw the ball away. We can't just keep throwing the ball away and we down 10. He got to try to make something happen. I miss Frank Wright with a passion. He got to try to make something happen sometime. Come on. I don't know. I don't know if Kelsey had vertigo. I don't know if he was dizzy when he was snapping the ball. But some of them shits ain't even get off the ground. Some of those balls didn't even leave the ground. It's like he rubbed it on the turf. And rolled it to Carson Wentz. I think Jalen Hurts got 3 career fumbles. 2 was off bad snaps. He out there playing bowling. He's playing bowling with a football. Come on, bro. But they're not going to. Orlando Scandrick will not talk about that, though. They're always going to talk about Carson Wentz. Because those dudes jealous that he got paid. He deserved it. They jealous that he got paid. And their whole thing is that he should have never got paid before Dak Prescott. They want to make sure their buddy get paid. Everybody wants to say he ain't worth the bread. What are y'all talking about? Do y'all know how much these other dudes are about to get paid? So let me ask you this. Is Deshaun Watson worth the bread? Ain't they 2-6? Are they 2-6 or not? Is Deshaun Watson worth the bread he just got paid? I'll wait. And that's not even for me to decide or for me to discuss. But if we going off all y'all logic, he's a $128 million quarterback. Okay. What's the excuses for Deshaun Watson then? Oh, well, he ain't got no coach. We don't either. Our coach giving a press conference right now telling us a bunch of Dr. Seuss stories. Lamar about to get overpaid because you have to pay him because of what Patrick Mahomes just got. You know what I'm saying? You have to pay Lamar. Lamar don't look that good. Deshaun Watson having a mediocre season. Mediocre? He's 2-6. He having a worse season than our quarterback from a winning standpoint because that's his job, right? Supposed to win. Am I going to watch NBA draft tonight? Probably not. I'm probably just going to see where LaMelo go, and that's going to be it for me. I don't care what the Sixers do. I don't care what they do. They running right here getting swept in the playoffs. But maybe Doc can help us out with that. Would you trade Fletcher to get better? Would I trade Fletcher Cox to get better right now? I know how important Fletcher Cox is. I know how important Fletcher Cox is. So I'm gonna go with a no. You down bad. I'm not even really down. It's just that I'm tired. Listen, when Doug Peterson told us that he thought the play calling was good, and for Carson Wentz to be cheerleading with that has me very upset. Because I'm an honest person. He should have said no comment. By him saying he thought it was good means that he'll never give it up. His ego is way too huge. He'll never give it up. Not in a million years will he give up the play calling. He had to get relinquished by Lurie, which is why Lurie is in his thumbnail. Lurie has to be the one to pull the card. Is that the GM's job? I don't know. These GMs so dumb. They've been raising the market, trying to keep players happy. Now they can't even afford players. No, they can't afford nothing. This is the thing about Carson Wentz. Whether we like him or not, we stuck with him because we paid him. We paid them and we over the cap. Whether we like him or not, we're stuck with him. It's not a lot of teams that's going to take that money on. It's not. And then if you do find a team to take the money on, what's your next move? Hey, Lil Brunson, someone said that something that caught my attention. The first time Carson don't play hero ball like everybody asking, this game wasn't close. That's what I'm saying. Carson Wentz ain't play hero ball last week. No turnovers last week. So what's your problem with Carson Wentz after this week? What's your problem with this game? No turnovers. You can't blame it on that. He actually made some pretty, pretty good throws, if you ask me. They 2-7 buns. He made some pretty good throws, if you ask me. What's your problem with him this week? The loss? This wasn't a Carson Wentz game to win. This was a run the ball down their throat game. We stopped running the ball. I have no problem with Carson Wentz's performance last week. He was put in an awkward position. Y'all need to trade Jalen Hurts and get some picks back, bruh. Let him go somewhere else where he could blossom, because this ain't it. Y'all want Jalen Hurts to run this system that Carson Wentz running? Y'all think Jalen Hurts could do better? You kidding me, man. The loss was on Doug Peterson for not running the ball. That's who the loss was on, for not running the ball. If Doug Peterson runs the ball, Miles Sanders probably get a $140. Boston might even get a buck. He had a 60-yard run. We could have had 300 yards rushing in this game, bro, if Doug Peterson run the ball. I tell you, man. But he don't think nothing was wrong with his play calling. How we paid Javon Hargrave, that was an L. I don't think so. Don't we put every loss on Doug, though? No. The first half of the season was on Carson Wentz. Miles Sanders' career is on Doug Peterson. Miles Sanders only having one 20-yard rushing game. It's ridiculous, bro. And that's a direct reflection of Doug Peterson. Brunson, I watched some film from years back. The offense has no creativity. The play when he went to Ward on the right, everyone ran the same route. We can't fool nobody with this offense. Offense is trash. The offense is the play design is no creativity at all, man. We got all these consultants, man. Man, I think my Jamaican truck about to pack up, man. I'm about to go get my food, man. But we got an official video coming, man. Official video coming later. We're going to talk about it. We're going to further discuss what's going on. Yo, what size is the blazer? It's not really a blazer. It's actually like a full length. It's like a, it's pretty long. It's like a full length jacket. It's from Top Man. You know, Top Man, they make European sizes. So I had to get like a 2X. I'm usually an extra large. But, you know, they make like European cut stuff. But, I got it from Nordstrom's. They got the little Top Man section. It was last year, though. They probably got new ones now. But, yo, we're going to get to it, man. Official video coming later on, man. I really appreciate you guys. You already know it's all love. We're going to continue to push the Eagles content creator culture forward. And you know what I'm saying? Make sure y'all wear y'all masks, bruh. Make sure y'all wear y'all masks. You know what I'm saying? These cases out here spiking. Make sure y'all wear y'all masks. You know what I'm saying? And to the lady that saw me in Wegmans who said she watched my videos and she said my team is trash, I want to tell you this, ma'am. Those peaches that you picked up was rotten. They was rotten. I hope you bite it on the rotten side. My team will get better. We're going through some tough times. You know what I'm saying? She right for sure. But don't walk up on me like it's sweet now. Listen, I'm a human being too. I don't just walk up to Cowboys fans like y'all trash. I don't do that. I do it with proper etiquette and proper respect. I just look at your Cowboys jersey and I just laugh under my mask. I ain't gonna say nothing to nobody, but I guess when people see your videos, you know what I mean? Say, oh, I didn't know you were that big in person. Oh, y'all trash, by the way. I was like, oh, yeah. Rotten ass peaches you just picked up. But you know, it is what it is, though. We're gonna continue to push the culture forward, man. I'm gonna get with y'all. Official video coming later. I gotta eat, man, so I get back to my desk. Successful lunchtime with the bullies, y'all already know.